So, ma'am, we will begin in a few minutes because I think people are logging in. So, I will let you know once we'll begin. Hello everyone, am I audible to all of you? Okay, so let's begin with our session. So welcome back to the fourth session of Coffee with Counselors, and our today's topic is mindset makeover. So I welcome you all to this fourth session of Coffee with Counselors, and our today's webinar facilitator is Ghazal Luthra ma'am. So ma'am is an author and creator of Neurocognitive Mind Hacking Blueprint. As a mindset makeover coach, ma'am has high potential to understand people, especially who face challenges in their work-life balance. She brings best solutions to ensure that nothing is impossible. And I hope that after this webinar session, you all would be, this webinar session would be beneficial to all of you. And now I am handing over to Ms. Ghazal Luthra ma'am, who will talk about this mindset. And in this whole webinar session of 40 minutes, she will talk about mindset. And after that, there will be a 10 minutes question and answer round. So ma'am, handing over to you now.
All right. So thank you, Prerna, for giving such an amazing introduction. And before we begin, I would really like to acknowledge each one of you for showing up today. And I'm sure you had some time constraints and work priorities, but you guys still made it. Thus, I'll make sure that I give you the best value of your time invested. So we're going to begin on time because I'm very particular about time, and time is one commodity which is completely same for everyone. So we're going to use the time and we're going to begin right now. So in this session, I'm going to share that what are those top three takeaways that you are going to get. Number one, you will identify your life challenges and you will understand that how your life, what is the reason behind the way you are facing the challenges. Second, as an educator, you will expand your awareness and you will feel more powerful after what I share with you guys today. And thirdly, you will learn the super effective hacks that will make you more productive. So if you guys are interested, please type yes, interested. And give me some energy so that I can continue with my session. So please type yes, interested. Okay, I'm waiting if people can type yes, interested. This will give me a lot of energy and encouragement to share my learnings with all of you. All right. Thank you so much, Anurag, for showing your interest. And I'm going to begin. I'm going to share some very amazing hacks with all of you. Thank you, Ranju. Thank you so much. So with these three top takeaways, I'm going to now continue my session. So if I ask you at this point, those people who are already in, I would want to quote a question to all of you. I call myself a mindset makeover coach. So if I ask you that according to you, what do you think? How important is the mindset? So I would request you, if you can give me this answer in the percentage, like 10%, 20, 30, 40. So what is that percentage that you feel is important in your life to be successful, having a good mindset? Please give that percentage to me. Okay, whatever you feel, you can just write that whatever you are feeling, whatever percentage is required to be successful, 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, whatever. So please mention the percentage. Okay, 33%. All right, that's great, Anurag. Anybody else has any guess or what kind of percentage? Prerna says 70%. Okay, Prerna, what else? Ranju says 70%. Good. All right. Okay, so if you ask me, then the success recipe says that if you want to be successful in life in any area of your life, any means any area, then you need to have 80% of mindset and 20% of strategy. Yes, only and only 20% of strategy. Strategy means the kind of skills you have, the kind of knowledge you have, experience you have, or the resources you have, or the skill sets you have, tactics you have, everything. That comprises of only 20%. And what is important is 80% of a strong mindset. So imagine the kind of importance that mindset has. And today I'm going to bring a lot of awareness by improving your mindset and making you guys more and more productive. So here it is. So here are some hacks which I'm sharing with all of you. Keeping in mind that you all are educators, I also was working in an education sector for almost a decade, and then I became a mindset makeover coach. So I clearly empathize, I clearly understand that what are the challenges or, you know, what are the hard-pressed situations that people go through. And keeping that in mind, I have prepared this small talk where I feel that you people are surely going to benefit. So the first thing and the first mind hack which I want to give you is that what matters most is how you see yourself. So it really does not matter what people think about you. What really matters is what you think about your own self. And when I say that, I'm going to clearly talk about one thing, and that is called self-communication. Self-communication. Now here, I'm not talking about communicating with others, because firstly, we need to have a very strong mindset. Our inner self should be so strong, because everything is originating from inside and then going to external world. It is never, never the opposite. It is never from outside to in. It is always from inside to out. So we are going to talk about self-communication today. In the self-communication, I mean to say that what is that kind of communication that you are doing with your own self? Aap kis tarah ki baatein apne aap se karte hain? 99% times we are not even aware the way we treat ourselves, and we are the result of whatever we are communicating to our own self. So if you wish to see that, you need to see and analyze your present situation. Aaj ki date mein aapki jo bhi present situation hai aur kisi bhi area mein, whether it is your wealth, health, or your relationships or your job, anything, it is purely because the way you see your own self. So here, basically, it's a very vast topic, but I've picked up key, you know, top three points, which I'm going to share with you. And the first one is mistake. Second is habits. And the third is called self-image. All right. So first is mistakes. Now, whenever we are working, we are bound to make mistakes, because without mistakes, people can't progress. So it's a good thing to make mistakes, right? But often what happens when we make mistakes, we don't treat ourselves very good. The kind of communication we have with our own self when we are making a mistake is something like this. For example, aap bahar ja rahe hain aur aap apne ghar ki chabi bhul gaye. Ya aap apne car ko parking lot mein aapne park kiya and you forgot to lock the car. And the moment you go ahead, ekdam se mind mein aata hai, shit, I'm so stupid. I'm such an idiot. I forget my keys every time. I'm such a duffer. I have a very bad memory. So this is the kind of communication, unintentionally, unknowingly, internal dialogues we are doing with our own self. And our mind's job is to gauge the conversation which is happening and making each and every word that we are speaking to a blueprint. So when you are talking in this language to your own self, your mind says, all right, I get that. Okay, you think you're a duffer. You think you're a stupid. You think you're not good enough. You're not smart enough. Good. Fine. I'll give you that more. So this is how we distort our self-image. We distort our identity. and over a period of time in many situations, we make our mistakes our identity. Our mistakes become our identity. But this is not the case. Our mistakes are totally different from our identity. They are not our identity. They are a part, a very minimalistic part of our identity. So then what should we do? How can we improve the self-communication, especially when we are doing these kind of mistakes? So here is the hack. If you are interested to know the hack, please give me energy and type yes. I want to know. Type yes. If you want to know that how you can improve your conversation and not treat yourself as a guilty person or as a victim, then say yes. I'm going to give you a very strong hack and it's really going to help you guys. Thank you so much. Thank you, Rashmi. Thank you, Hardik. Thank you, Mayank. Thank you, Ranju, for giving me the energy. I truly love you guys. You guys are so amazing and giving me so much of energy to continue. Okay, so listen to me carefully now. What is the hack? The hack is that you need to tell your mind those words which your mind does not understand. And they should have the very, you know, I would say less intensity. The intensity should not be strong. It should not be clearly understandable by your mind. So for example, if you make a mistake, just say, oh, I'm being so silly Billy. Oh, I'm being so naughty, right? Oh, I'm such a nincompoop. Or you can have your own, you know, words which you can frame and they should have a very, very milder meaning or should not clearly be meaningful to your mind. Because see, when you make a mistake, you need to have an internal dialogue. Dialogue to aapko karna hi padega internal because that's the demand of the situation. But that is the only time when you need to dialogue yourself, right? So don't ever treat yourself by giving very heavy synonyms to your mistake or making yourself an identity out of it. Just use very mild, silly Billy, naughty, being very casual, whatever, and replace your self-communication by using these words. So this is a very important hack and this will make your self-image very, very strong. So one is that. Then number two, we're coming to the habits. Now I clearly understand that the kind of profession you are extremely hard pressed with the time. I have never ever seen a fraternity working harder than this fraternity, the education sector. My heart and soul is with each one of you because I truly understand the kind of demotion you people are giving to the students and to your school and organization. So I truly salute you guys for the kind of hardship you are going through and for the kind of contribution you are doing to make things better. The point is that we are making our habits or we have already made our habits. Some of the habits are not very encouraging. Bahut sare logon ko bahut sare kaam karne pasand nahi hai. But the thing is that you know how the habits are formed. The habits are formed the way we communicate with our own self. The habits don't come just like that. It is us who have made these habits. Now, for example, you don't like to do paperwork. So most of the people say, I hate doing paperwork. I hate getting up in the morning. I don't like to do ERP. I don't like to take a WE. Or I don't like to do this work. I don't like to generate report. I don't want to make attendance register. Whatever. Anything related to your work. Now, what is happening? Every time you have to do it because it is your job. It is mandatory to do these things. There is no escape from that. But since the way you are communicating with your mind says, I get that you don't like it, but you still need to do it. So continue doing it with this energy, with this stress, and with this kind of a mindset, which is not going to make you comfortable at all. We are going to continue with the same mindset. When this kind of a thing happens, these habits, they sap your energy and they take a lot of toll on you because obviously we don't like to do things which we don't want. So now in this case, habits can be changed. Habits can be really changed. But dear friends, there is a catch in that. There is really a catch in that. And that catch is that people say that the day I start getting up early, I will start exercising. I will start going to gym. I will start losing weight. No, first You need to do the work and then you will make the habit. You're not going to get up on your own. You need to make a habit out of it. So you will say that I am doing this now every day. I'm taking small, small, small baby steps to inculcate a habit, to change a habit so that I know that it works for me, not against me. And secondly, whenever we have these kind of habits, then the communication that we have with our mind, हमने अपने माइंड को तो ये बता दिया कि आई डोंट लाइक इट, बट हैव यू टोल्ड योर माइंड व्हाट यू लाइक इट? यू डोंट लाइक दिस, यू टोल्ड योर माइंड, बट हैव यू टोल्ड योर माइंड व्हाट यू लाइक इट? नो, यू आर सेइंग दैट आई डोंट लाइक टू गेट अप इन द मॉर्निंग, बट हैव यू टोल्ड योर माइंड दैट व्हाट यू लाइक इट? यू वुड लव टू गेट अप इन द मॉर्निंग सो दैट यू कैन टेक केयर ऑफ योर हेल्थ. वी हैव नॉट, एंड वी थिंक दैट इट इज क्लियरली अंडरस्टैंडेबल. That mind will understand that since I can't get up in the morning, that's the reason I can't do my exercises and I can't stay fit. You need to be very, very precise with your mind to change your habits. So habits will only change once you start changing your self-communication. So don't emphasize on what you don't want. Start emphasizing on what you want. Certain things which are inevitable, like doing your paperwork, generating reports. Make better statements for yourself. Say that this work is important for me. Doing paperwork is important for me. Writing mails to parents or to students is important for me. Because this is something which you need to do. There is no escape. But you can surely change the relationship and the kind of energy which you are getting yourself by doing these habits. So this is the second hack which I'm giving you to change your self-communication and develop good habits, inculcate good habits, encouraging habits. If you feel that this is useful, please go ahead and type useful. Please go ahead and type useful. Okay, Hardik, you are a student, but this is applicable for every single person. So you don't have to worry, even if it is teachers or students, whatever. So I'm just taking, you know, the context is of the teachers, but of course it is applicable for students as well. Right. Okay, this is useful. Thank you, Rashmi. Thank you so much. All right, so then now I'm moving ahead with the third. Now see, this third one is extremely, extremely, extremely useful. And this is called self-image. Most of the people in this world are successful only because they have worked upon their self-image. It does not matter what people think about you or how they see you. What matters is how you see your own self. Do you see yourself as an empowered person? Listen, if you want to grow in life, then you need to have your self-image larger than your goals. I can see there are some students also, and that's the reason I am, you know, giving now more examples in that context. So if you have set goals in life, your self-image should be larger than that goal. Then only you will be able to achieve goals. Some people who want to achieve a lot in life, for instance, the people who are teachers, they want to open their own school or they want to, you know, become principal or they want to come in the management. This is fantastic. But till the time you don't see yourself inside within you, you will not be able to do it. Your mind should believe that you can achieve. Till the time you don't believe it, you will never, ever be able to do it. So self-image can be improved by doing simple, simple, simple things. And these simple things are, I'm sharing with you now. So first thing, the simple self-image technique that you can do is always accept self-praise graciously. जब भी आपको कोई praise कर रहा है, बिल्कुल ये मत बोलिए अरे नहीं नहीं मैं तो इस लायक नहीं हूँ या इसमें कौन सी बड़ी बात है ये तो सब कर लेते हैं अरे नहीं आप ये तो आपका बड़प्पन है. Never ever say that. If you start rejecting the self-praise, the praise will not come to you because your mind will quickly understand that you don't deserve it, you don't like it. So it will stop giving you those situations that would make sure that self-praise comes to you. So stop doing rejecting self-praise. Self-praise is a part of our life. We, as human beings, we need a lot of self-praise. And always, always embrace self-praise with a lot of love and gratitude. Say, thank you. I truly acknowledge. Thank you. Very kind of you. I know I've done a good job. Keep patting your back. So Forget anybody's patting it or not. Keep patting your own back, even for doing small things. And this is going to enhance your self-image. Also, there are some people who are suffering from a self-image problem. And that's the reason they get into something known as a Kaaba syndrome. So anybody has heard about a Kaaba syndrome? Please type yes or no. Kaaba syndrome. Okay, so I am sharing this with you, a Kaaba syndrome. This is a very, very common, but it's it is 100% two syndrome. And many a times people go through this. Now that this Kaaba syndrome, C-A-B-A, Kaaba syndrome is known as Chota Aadmi Bada Aadmi syndrome. All right. We in our own mind, with our own judgment, we make images for us and for people. And then we start naming them, tagging them, judging them. And we say, अरे मैं तो छोटा आदमी हूँ, वो बड़ा आदमी है, या यू नो ये मेरे लिए छोटा काम है, उसके लिए बड़ा काम है. इफ यू वॉन्ट टू बी अ बिलियनर, देन यू विल से हम तो बहुत छोटे लोग हैं यार, हम तो स्टेप बाय स्टेप ही चलेंगे ना. दे आर लाइक देयर, दे आर द पीपल हु आर रूलिंग द वर्ल्ड, दे आर द क्रीम ऑफ द पीपल. सो हमने बहुत सारी चीजों के लिए अपने माइंड में काबा सिंड्रम बना के रखा हुआ है, छोटा आदमी बड़ा आदमी, राइट? एंड दैट लीड्स टू लॉट ऑफ अंडर कॉन्फिडेंस इन अस. It is affecting our self-image very silently. Everything is happening at the background. We don't even realize it, because I don't have the time to go into the details today, but you must have heard, or if you've not, then please make a note. You are 95% programmed. Whatever programming is already done inside you, you are just an outcome of that. So when people say that I am thinking, people are not thinking. It's a habitual thinking. जो आपने कल सोचा था, परसों सोचा था, 10 दिन पहले सोचा था, 6 महीने पहले सोचा था, 90% ऑफ थॉट्स आपके वो ही होते हैं. और अगर आपकी धीरे धीरे, बिकॉज हालात की वजह से आपने अपने ऊपर काम नहीं किया है, उसकी वजह से अगर आपकी सेल्फ इमेज डाउन होती जा रही है, प्लीज बी केयरफुल, स्टार्ट चेंजिंग योर सेल्फ इमेज, बिकॉज सेल्फ इमेज इज द नंबर वन की एरिया to be successful in life. If you want to be successful, self-image has to be really, really strong. Okay? So I hope this makes sense. If it is making sense, please type make sense. Please type make sense. MS. It's a you know, time of short form, so you can write MS. Thank you, Rashmi. Okay, thank you, Ade. Thank you, Annie. Thank you. Great. All right. Thank you so much. Makes sense. Okay, thank you. So I am now continuing further. I am very happy that you guys have understood and you know now that what is the importance of self-communication. So with this, I am moving into the another area now. Now, this is an area which is very important, especially for students who want to excel in life. And parents, if you are here in this platform, and the teachers, everybody, we all as human beings have to work on this. And these are called beliefs. Your beliefs are your world. And Henry Ford said it very right. He said that whether you think you can or you think you can't, you are right. You are absolutely right. So what are beliefs? Basically, belief is something that you feel it is true for yourself, not for me, not for others. जो भी चीज या जो भी स्टेटमेंट आप सोचते हैं कि सही है, वो आपके लिए सही है, मेरे लिए सही नहीं है. बिकॉज जैसे कुछ लोग बोलेंगे, लाइफ इज ब्यूटिफुल एंड आई लव टू टेक चैलेंजेस. सम पर्सन वुड से लाइफ इज वेरी हार्ड, लाइफ इज डिफिकल्ट एंड वी नीड टू स्ट्रगल टू गेट इनटू यू नो द ग्रूव और टू गेट इनटू एक्शन. पीपल हैव डिफरेंट बिलीव्स. सम पीपल फील दैट यू नो हेल्थ कैन इजीली बी मेंटेन इफ यू आर लिटिल केयरफुल. सम पीपल से हेल्थ टू मेंटेन हेल्थ एट दिस टाइम इज वेरी डिफिकल्ट. So these are your beliefs which are ruling and governing your world. And whatever you believe is whatever the outcome you are giving today. So again, if you see yourself in different areas, whatever outcomes you have got as of now in different areas of your life, that is because of your belief. Because belief is the biggest operating system inside you, which is making you do actions every single day. So beliefs have to be very carefully changed. Now, changing is not that easy, because as per the mind goes, once the beliefs are formed, you cannot delete any belief, you can just replace it. So that's the reason in this topic, I'm going to speak more about only students, because as teachers, I feel it is our duty and we need to be very careful that what kind of beliefs we are inculcating in students, right? So there was a study, I will share a very interesting study with all of you. There was a study which was done in Australia, and in there they observed 1000 families, so normal families. And unhone wahan dekha ke jab ek bachcha 1 year to 18 years tak pahunchta hai, to uske jo programs bante hain wo kitne hote hain aur kis tarah ke hote hain. Unhone ye paya ke on an average every day a normal family use 23 do's and don'ts or can'ts. You can't do this, you can't do that, or you don't have the capability, you know, the statement starting from do, don't, can't 23 times. So that makes it 148 times by the time a child grows to 18 years of age. So you can imagine we all are product where these things are already installed inside us. But still, we are doing very well. But there is a lot and lot and lot of scope for us to improve if we are successful in changing these beliefs. So if you see this one, these are the kind of things which mostly parents say to their children, or sometimes teachers, and sometimes, you know, family friends or the others, people who are closely associated. Like, you are lazy, you are stupid. Friends say you are such a jerk. You can't do anything good. You can't even talk properly. So. And you are not even confident, you are so clumsy, you can't do anything right, can't you see that, you know, you are not good at this, stop doing this. All these things are already running inside a child's mind. We need to be very, very careful. We need to surely see that the kind of communication we are having with the children. That's the reason when I talk to people, in fact, I was one of the product, I was shit scared of public speaking. I used to avoid it big time. But even if my job demanded, I used to know that I used to have so much of anxiety before I had to speak. And I would take at least, you know, 2-3 hours to settle down after I've given my performance. It was so bad. It was all coming from somewhere here. When in my childhood, I was probably told that you can't talk properly, you're good for nothing. People will make fun of you. Your conversation skills are not good. You don't look good when you talk, whatever. So this is how our beliefs are formed. Children needs to be given empowering beliefs every day, every single day. Please make sure, if you are a parent, please work with your children and give them empowering beliefs for any situation. So for instance, I will tell you an incident that what happened when my son, it was like just 2 years back. So there was an exam going on, and my son went and he gave an exam, and then he came back. So when he came back, I asked him how was the exam, and he was very sad. I asked what happened. He said that I studied the wrong chapter. And I was like, oh, why? He said, because I was not in the class. I was going for some practices, so I missed the syllabus, and somebody gave me the wrong information. I studied the wrong chapter. So I said, now what? He said, so I've learned that I should not be trusting anyone. So I said that I think there is a different perspective to it. How about saying that I should be rechecking, or I should be, you know, I should be more responsible and take the responsibility for my own action. The reason I'm telling you this incident is that we all go through such situations, but there is one key point that you must take. And that key point is that whatever the situation is, make sure that your child walks away with a correct belief, with an empowering belief. So it is our job, it is our responsibility as parents and teachers to ensure that we are inculcating empowering and good beliefs in our children. All right. So is it good? Is it good or great? Please type good or great. If you feel it is good, type good. If you feel it is great, type great. Okay. Thank you, Rashmi. How about others? Is it good or great? Thank you so much. Thank you, Annie. Devina, thank you so much. Great. So now for the parents and for the children here, I am giving you 3 questions. You need to ask these 3 questions every day, and you will see the change. As a parent, if your child is small, please help the child to answer these questions. And if you are an adult, then do it your own self. So first question that you must ask yourself every day is, what was the best thing I did today? So before you retire in the evening, before you go to sleep, just close your eyes and think, what was one best thing that I did today? Okay. And then take an answer out of it and just keep it to yourself. The second question that you need to ask is that, what are those five things that you are grateful for? So just ask the child that, you know, out of today's routine or today's scenario, what are those five things that you feel you are grateful? And you'll be surprised with the answers. There could be even very, you know, I would say cute answers like the, you know, mom, the way you smiled at me, or you gave me your 10 minutes and we played this game together, whatever. You will be surprised. But what is it doing to your mind? It is creating that energy. It is creating that confidence. It is creating that belief that you mean a lot to others and you mean a lot to yourself. So this is very important. And the third question that you need to ask is, one thing that you could have done better, that you could do better. So ask the child that, okay, you've done a lot of things today. Now, what do you think, out of any one thing, which thing do you feel you could have done better? All right. Now, यहाँ पे क्या होता है, parents ना बहुत ज्यादा judgmental होते हैं और अपने views देने शुरू कर देते हैं. I would strongly suggest and recommend, don't give your views till the time you are asked for it. Let the child speak. Let the child have his own understanding, his own awareness. Don't ever say it just because, you know, you need to show the, that authority or probably that I know it better. No, this is not the time. And the purpose of doing this exercise is not to correct the child at that time. It is just to bring the awareness. And the awareness that comes from within, from, you know, from my own self, is the biggest awareness. Awareness should be created by your own self rather than by being imposed by others. So these are the three empowering questions that I'm giving you. And I request everyone, if you can just take a screenshot or just note it down, because start doing this every day and you will feel the difference, that these three questions are very powerful and they're going to inculcate some nice and empowering belief in yourself and your child. Okay, so I'll just give like 10 seconds, 10, 15 seconds for you to take a snapshot. And then I'll move forward. Okay, guys, do you think it is nice? Okay, thank you, Annie. And I'll be taking question answers down in the end, so don't worry. So whatever you feel that you are not able to understand or you don't have a clarity, just make a note of it. I'm surely, surely going to address to everything. Okay, thank you. All right, so now I'm moving. Now this is one thing. This is one word which everybody knows. Every single person uses it so frequently, like it's, you know, it's like an air everywhere. So it's like stress. Whatever you say, and say, I'm very stressed. I'm very stressed. Bahut stress chal raha hai life mein. Padhne ka stress hai. Kaam karne ka stress hai. Or, you know, healthy rehne ka stress hai, ghar ka kaam karna hai. So everybody says, yaar, bahut stress chal raha hai life mein. So I'm asking you guys, whosoever would wish to answer, what do you think, is stress a positive word or a negative word? What is your understanding about this word? What is your understanding? Is it positive or is it negative? Negative, right. Okay. Anybody else? Is it positive or is it negative? Negative for sure, Hardik. Okay. All right. Okay. Who else? What do you feel? Okay, come on, Devina. What do you feel? Is it positive or negative? As children, we also feel that children, of course, children get stressed. Anurag says positive. All right. That's very... you know, encouraging to know that it's positive for Anurag. Okay, Annie. Okay, Devina says positive. Okay, Devina, good. All right, so here I'm giving some awareness now, again, at a very superficial level because I don't have time to go into the detail. But when we talk about this word stress, right? This word stress is definitely negative for someone and definitely positive for others. So stress itself is a neutral word. It is absolutely a neutral word. See, I'll tell you why. our body is programmed to take stress. And that means, I'm just giving a very, very brief introduction. How does our body work? Whenever there is a dangerous situation, dangerous means stress ka matlab hota hai, anything which you feel you are not capable of doing it or handling it at that moment. And that's the reason you feel overwhelmed, you feel stressed about. क्योंकि आपको लगता है यार अब मैं ये कैसे करूंगी यार, ये तो बहुत ज्यादा हो गया, या मुझे नहीं पता ये कैसे होगा, अब ये नया काम आ गया, राइट? सो स्ट्रेस इज समथिंग व्हिच यू फील यू आर इनकेपेबल ऑफ डूइंग इट एट दैट पॉइंट ऑफ टाइम, राइट? दैट क्रिएट्स स्ट्रेस. बॉडी इज प्रोग्राम टू टेक द स्ट्रेस. अगर हमारी बॉडी में स्ट्रेस नहीं होगा ना, तो हमारी बॉडी फंक्शन नहीं करेगी, हमारी बॉडी एक्शन नहीं लेगी. पहले जमाने में स्ट्रेस इसलिए होता था बिकॉज इट यूज टू activate a fight or flight system. जैसे सामने से शेर आ गया तो एकदम से आपके बॉडी में एक स्ट्रेस सिस्टम होता है जो एक्टिवेट हो जाता है, एंड इट गिव्स यू अ चॉइस दैट वेदर यू लाइक टू फाइट द सिचुएशन और यू वुड लाइक टू रन एंड सेव योर लाइफ. दैट इज इंपॉर्टेंट बिकॉज अगर आपको सिग्नल ही नहीं आ रहा है तो आप उसमें काम कैसे करेंगे? आप खड़े रहेंगे और शेर आके आपको खा जाएगा. अब आज के टाइम में शेर तो है नहीं, बट वी हैव क्रिएटेड सम फॉल्स स्टिम्युलेटर्स विच False stimulators have become stress. जैसे कि बॉस का फोन आ गया रात को 9 बजे जो कि अनएक्सपेक्टेड है, स्ट्रेस हो गया, राइट? या फिर रात को 2 बजे आपने देखा हस्बैंड व्हाट्सएप कर रहा है एंड आपको पता नहीं किससे कर रहा है, आपको स्ट्रेस हो गया. या आपको बोला गया कि 2 दिन में ये सारा काम करके देना है, आपको स्ट्रेस हो गया. सो दिस इज हाउ योर बॉडी इज रिस्पॉन्डिंग बिकॉज ऑफ द एक्सटर्नल फैक्टर्स. एनी वेज, स्ट्रेस इज गुड इफ इट स्टेज फॉर सम टाइम बिकॉज दैट्स इट्स जॉब टू सेव यू फ्रॉम दैट सिचुएशन. That immediate situation. आज की डेट में प्रॉब्लम क्या हो रही है? स्ट्रेस हमारी लाइफ में 24/7 365 डेज जमा हुआ है. तो देर इज नो ऑन ऑफ बटन, इट इज ऑलवेज ऑन. बिकॉज कभी पढ़ाई का स्ट्रेस है, तो कभी काम का स्ट्रेस है, तो कभी पेरेंट्स का स्ट्रेस है, कभी किसी और चीज का स्ट्रेस है, लेकिन स्ट्रेस तो चल ही रहा है. नाउ जब स्ट्रेस पूरे टाइम ऑन है तो स्ट्रेस इज नॉट बींग गुड टू अस, इट इज बींग बैड टू अस. एंड दैट सेज दैट स्ट्रेस मेक्स अस लेस इंटेलिजेंट. That's the reason when a child is in stressful state, he forget the answers which he had studied thoroughly for his exams. But just because the mindset or the situation was not very, very, you know, calm to take care of the situation, stress overcomes and it takes the, you know, the intelligence of the person. It makes that person less intelligent at that time. So then the thing is that stress is not a problem. It is our reaction towards it. और जिस तरह से हम किसी सिचुएशन को देखते हैं उसी तरह से हम उसको रिएक्ट करते हैं, और वो ही कारण बनता है कि हम स्ट्रेस में जाएंगे कि नहीं जाएंगे. सो दैट मींस दैट द वन सॉल्यूशन दैट यू हैव टू इज टू चेंज योर परसेप्शन. अगर आप अपना लाइफ का परसेप्शन चेंज कर देंगे तो आपको उस सिचुएशन जो स्ट्रेस दे रही है वो आपको स्ट्रेस देना बंद कर देगी. सी, वी ऑल आर सीइंग दिस वर्ल्ड through wearing, you know, glasses of our own. हम अपने glasses पहन के इस दुनिया को देख रहे हैं और हमें वही चीजें दिख रही है क्योंकि हम सब ने अपने अपने glasses पहने हुए. But आपको बैठ के ये देखना है कि अगर उन glasses से आपको दुनिया उस हिसाब की नहीं दिख रही जिस हिसाब की आप चाहते हैं, then please change your glasses. I wear the glasses of awesomeness because I want to see every single person awesome in this world. I want to see every single person growing, living, and being happy. So what kind of glasses are you wearing? Change your perception. There is a very common example. Ek glass hai pani ka, aadha bhara hai, aadha khali hai. How come? The situation is same, but people look at it from a different point of view. So if you feel that in any area you are getting stressed, change the perception, change the communication. You will understand that stress is not coming because of the outer situation. It is because of your own perception. Okay, so you need to remember the 3 P's. This is $1 million formula I am giving you, but I'm going to give it to only those who say yes to me. If you say yes, then I'm going to give, otherwise I'm not going to give. Okay. All right. Thank you, Alabya. Thank you, Annie, Rashmi. Thank you, Devina. Thank you, Prerna. All right. Okay. Thank you so much for giving me this energy. And I'm sharing you with this formula. This is a very important formula. If you remember these 3 P's always in your life, I assure you that the level of stress is surely going to go down in your life. So the three P's that before you come through any situation, you come across any situation in your life, and before you react to it, just remember these three P's. So first P is it permanent? Aap agar bahar ja rahe hain by chance, or you are in the car, और आपकी कार को पीछे से किसी ने ठोक दिया, ओके? Of course, you will get up and you will get angry. But before that, if you just take a pause and you say that, is this situation permanent in my life? You will see, you will change the perception. You will change the level of stress and anxiety that you would have developed by not thinking about this. No, it is not permanent. ऐसा तो नहीं है कि जब भी हम घर से निकलते कोई ना कोई गाड़ी ठोक के चला जाता है. ऐसा नहीं होता है, बिल्कुल नहीं होता है. So this is not permanent. It is just one situation. So change your perception to have a different reaction to it. All right. Now, the second P is it persistent? Persistent matlab, kya ye aapke saath din raat ho raha hai? Nahin ho raha hai bhi. Din raat to bilkul nahin ho raha hai. Kabhi kabhi hota hai. Once in a blue moon hota hai. So then there is no reason to get stressed. It is not persistent. Just change your perception and you will see the difference happening. And the last one. Is it personal? Did that person जिसने आपकी गाड़ी को bang किया, क्या वो ये सोच के तो नहीं निकला था कि मैं इसके आज मैं personally I am going to hit the car? No, he's not going to do that, right? So this is not personal. So if I strongly recommend, अगर आपकी life में कोई भी situation है और इन three P's में से अगर आपके situation में दो P's बैठते हैं properly, that yes, I feel that person, was not good to me and he made a remark which was purely personal to me and he has been doing this since so many days, then you surely react. But otherwise, if you feel that in me se sirf ek hi cheez ho rahi hai ya ek bhi nahi hai, then please change your perspective for that situation. And I assure you that you will be definitely changing the perspective. So I hope this is going to help you in taking care of the stress. All right. So here I've given a very new meaning to the stress, and that is called situation to respond enthusiastically, sensibly, and smartly. So don't think that stress is a negative statement. It is up to you how you are taking it. So I always take stress in a positive manner because I know that how I am going to respond to the situation by being little enthusiastically, sensibly, and smartly. So this is the form that is a new form. Keep that in mind, and I'm sure you will be able to take a lot of things easily in your life. So this is my last slide, and this is one of my favorite slide. And this says that our life is from B to D. That means B is birth and D is death. And in between, there is an alphabet, and that alphabet is called C. And C means choice. So you have a choice. You have always have a choice in every situation, whether you want to complain or you want to celebrate. So make your choices very wisely because you have been given a life and that life has to be thoroughly enjoyed. So my gratitude and grace to Fair Grace for giving me this opportunity to speak to you. I hope my session was really meaningful. I could add some value in your life. And thank you so much. And now I am all yours and set for the question answer round. Thank you.
Okay. So to all the lovely audience here, hearing to us, we would like to announce that we are also live on Fairgaze website, on Fairgaze Facebook page. So if you have any queries, you can also send our questions there. And now moving on further to our participants' queries. So I'll unmute one by one and. So Hardik has asked that may I know the second hack now? So I'll do one thing, that I'll unmute Hardik once and so that he can directly ask his question. Okay,
all right.
So just a moment, ma'am.
Okay, Hardik, I think I saw your query when I was taking the session. So I think it was first was mistake and second was habit, right? Would you like to ask more about the habit part?
So Hardik, you are unmuted. You can ask your question.
Hardik, are you there?
Yes. So, yes, I'd like to ask more about the habit part.
All right, great. So, Hardik, See, you need to sit and make a list of things which you feel that these habits are not very encouraging and they are not very, useful to you. And they are probably giving you a negative energy, right? So for example, you say that the kind of conversation that I don't like to study or I don't like to do maths or probably I don't like to give exams, whatever. I'm just giving examples according to students. So then you know that there is no escape from it, right? These are the things which are mandatory for you as a person, as a student to grow in life. So why not change a conversation, self-conversation? Because these habits have also been formed when you start saying this, when you started saying this at some point of time in your life. And today you have formed a habit of not liking these. So now what you're going to do is you're going to change your habit by changing the self-conversation. So you are going to say that I like to study maths, okay? Even if you don't, does not matter. It is just a matter of fooling your mind so that it gives you 100% cooperation to do the maths when you are actually doing it. So this is how you want to change your statements, make them positive. And if you are supposed lacking in getting up in the morning or eating healthy food, you are eating a lot of junk food, and you say that I don't like to eat healthy food, ghar ka khana mujhe pasand nahi hai, but I know agar main khana khana chhod dun bahar ka, toh I will be more healthy. So you know what you want, but your mind is overruling you by giving you these conversations that you don't like to eat home food. So you can change the conversation by say that I like to eat healthy food. Start with that. Now healthy food can be from outside, for instance, but start with baby steps, because if you give a totally opposite statement with a very strong command to your mind, it is going to revolt because it has a 95% control in whatever the paradigm has been set. So you need to do it very subtly, but in a very, very positive manner. I hope I'm been able to answer your query. Okay. Anyone else?
So, ma'am, I think the queries are over. We haven't received any further query yet. So, yeah. I would like to once again announce that we are live on Facebook page of Fair Gaze. So, if you have any queries, we are now going to close up our session. So, if you have any queries, kindly let us know that. And Hardik query is solved. Okay, thank you so much, Hardik.
All right. Anurag has written a query, but I don't know if I have time to take that or not. So Prerna, do we have a time or he can address the query in the Facebook page?
Ma'am, we have, if we'll receive any other query, we can discuss it now or else we'll close it now. So we are not receiving any query now. So
yeah, Anurag has written, if you want, then Bergai.
Anurag.
Is Anurag from your team?
Yeah, ma'am. He is from the digital team.
Okay, great.
He's from the digital team.
Yeah.
Okay. So let's close the session. Okay. So all the lovely audience, kindly also get your reviews on this webinar too, so that we can come back with these webinars. And thank you so much, ma'am, for your lovely words today. And thank you so much for telling your great views on mindset and stress. That was really useful for me too. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Thank you, Prerna. Thank you so much. Thoroughly enjoyed. Yeah, thanks. Bye-bye.
Thank you so much, ma'am.
Thank you. Thank you so much.